It's very heartening to see the optimism and energy in this room. But unfortunately, outside of this room, the world today is facing a crisis of compassion. There is fear, intolerance, and a lack of empathy for anyone that we believe is different from us. And all of this starts from our schools. For 15 years of our students' lives, we tell them that their education is incomplete if they do not study about photosynthesis, quadratic equations, the height of Mount Everest, and grammar. And in those 15 years, we don't have the time to tell them to care about inequality, child rights, and compassion. And then we worry, why are children not becoming creative, empathetic, collaborative citizens? Well, here's where design matters. David Kelly, of the founder of IDEO, very famously once said, "Everything you see around you is designed by man, except nature." That got us thinking that if we were born humans by chance, can we become humane by design? Isn't the whole purpose of education is to ensure that all children develop or graduate as citizen leaders, having passion and compassion, content and character, doing good and doing well? Well, hope was not a strategy, and hence, in 2001, Riverside started and embarked on this journey and this quest. And for 18 years now, we've been using the principles of design thinking to create the simple four-step ICANN formula. The ICANN formula empowers children to believe that they can be the change. The simple steps are, the first step is that of feel, where they identify the problem that they are facing and that bothers them. Imagine is taking responsibility of that change. Do is actually implementing their solution. And then share is developing the whole abundance mentality of sharing with as many people as they can to infect them with the ICANN mindset. And this is called the FIDS for Kids. And what the result was that we found children, they started believing that they're not helpless, change is possible, and that they can drive it. Here, I would like to show you a glimpse of how these powers are exercised by our students. The first story is about our very young children who took up the challenge of designing jewelry for raising funds for their older buddies who were working with cancer patients in a local hospital. Here, you'll see the children not only learn math and language, but you'll also see them being problem solvers, collaborators, and leaders. But the biggest lesson that we teachers learned from this was that age has nothing to do with competency.
Archana ma'am is a jewelry designer,
and she has put up her jewelry exhibition. Then we thought that we could also make this kind of jewelry.
Then we told Kiran ma'am about it. Kiran ma'am told us that
you can do an exhibition.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
So we said yes, but Kiran ma'am asked us that no, you can't do it. You can't do it. But we said no, we can do it. So she told in 10 days I want 5 jewelry pieces.
So we started looking at different materials, and we created our jewelry. But when we did the exhibition, Kiran ma'am didn't like our jewelry pieces.
Arey, I want this necklace. Look at the size of these beads. Right? And look at your pattern.
I can't wear it. It's too tight.
So we did a survey and ask different teachers which color do you want, where you will use it. In the second exhibition, we got lots of advance orders. But when the ma'am started using the jewelry pieces, the anklets broke. So then we were looking at quality. And we went to the shops. We were comparing, and we understood what was quality. We went to NID, what kind of tools they use to design or what material they use. We thought that we can help heal by selling our jewelry. Then we had made many designs, lots and lots of jewelry pieces.
So we put up a stall in an exhibition at Rajpath Club.
Customers were not believing that we have made this jewelry.
All our children graduate as citizen leaders, finding their passion. It could be medicine, economics, dancing, music, whatever that might be, and also finding compassion. And therefore, it is that last final moment that every graduating batch undergoes, which is called the insane experience. It's a two-day community immersion idea where they meditate, reflect, and find perspective. And we believe that they leave the school thinking that they're not in the world to compete, but to actually complete each other.
तीनों बातों को जोड़ना है तो तीनों की हार्मनी कैसे करेंगे? तीन दिन हम कैसे करें कि एक दिन ऐसा रखें हमारा हेड का उपयोग करें, दूसरे दिन हैंड और तीसरे दिन हार्ट.
I think it's best to go in without any expectations, you know, go in on a clean slate.
Just completely bungee jump into this experience.
Yep.
Every other experience has been more external. Mm-hmm. I think this is going to be a very internal experience and an internal
stage for us to do this.
Yes.
Was the rag picking experience, and we went to the Anganwadi school. Mm. We went to Maji's house, and we even took the Saturday special sessions. And throughout the day, I think the one thing that I have gauged and I have for now is respect.
Each of you is going to be taking that word that you talked about yesterday, respect. You're going to paint respect, okay? What the colors of respect are, what form of respect. So you are going to take respect back with you to hang in your room and forever remind you that was your moment. Roller coaster, order and chaos. Patience, respect and disparity.
There is no direct implication or, you know, expression that defines this painting, but in sense that at least to me it seems as if, you know, there's something, and then there's some understanding that you have of this world around you, and suddenly you are faced and hit by reality, and then it just explodes. So that's what this is about.
This is what the world needs: children who are empowered and inspired
to shape a more compassionate and human world, not by chance, but by design. And I would like to end with our Mahatma's quote: if we are to teach real peace and real change in this world, we shall have to begin with children. Thank you.